basketball fans and people across the country remembering Kobe Bryant, who lost his life in a helicopter crash yesterday, along with his 13-year-old daughter, seven others, including young athletes, mothers, and a coach. Well, tonight here in New York City, the iconic Empire State Building lit up in purple and gold in honor of the Lakers legend. I want to bring in Roger Mason Jr. He's a retired NBA player who is the former deputy executive director of the NBA Players Association. And we are so happy to have you here. Thank you so much. I really appreciate
it. No problem.
I know that is a tough time. You have a story about when you were playing. You were playing with the Spurs. You had a game one night against the Lakers. And your mom called you and said she had a few things to tell us that she wanted to tell you about, right? Tell us about that.
Yeah, no, I mean, I was just reminded of it. So I was playing for the Spurs, and game day, so my mom was calling about tickets, and this person needs to come, and that person needs to come. And I just said to my mom, you know, I got Kobe tonight. And so all the things that you're talking about, they don't really matter. And he just made you focus. You knew if you were going to be competing against him, you needed to bring your A game, because he was going to come with it. And my mom told me, today, she takes that with her every day. You know, when she's got something to focus on, she said, you know, I never forget when you said I got Kobe tonight. And I think that just speaks volumes to what he meant for people that not only played basketball, but, you know, people across all walks.
You then worked with Kobe in your role with the NBA Players Association. Did you see a different side of him then? Because you were competing with him on the court. What was that?
Yeah, I definitely saw a different side of him. I remember vividly we were on an elevator going downstairs during the NBA lockout. And so as players, the NBA family is very close. And so we were trying to get back to work. And Kobe, you know, he had that same tenacity. And he was like, all right, man, enough is enough. You know, let's get back to it. Let's focus in. Let's get back on the court. And so, you know, I never forget that. Never forget that elevator. Escalator ride down that hotel.
So LeBron spoke out tonight about his friend. Here's what he said. He said, I am not ready, but here I go. I'm heartbroken and devastated, my brother. So just this past Saturday night, LeBron passed Kobe on the all-time scoring list against the 76ers. What do you make? It's tough to lose someone you love like this, especially someone you look up to. How does one, someone like LeBron or anyone who's playing, how do you get back out there and do, because this is such a physical and intense mental.
Yeah, it's such a.
You carry your heart out there.
Yeah, it's such a mental game. And for someone like LeBron, I was fortunate to be his teammate. And he respects the greats. He respects the people that paved the way before him. And a guy like Kobe was larger than life. So to see a tragedy like this happen to our hero, to LeBron's hero, you just can't make any sense of it, and you gotta kind of go to that Mamba mentality that Kobe had to know that, you know, he would want LeBron to carry that torch. He would want LeBron to keep going.
Yeah, you know, I love the relationship that he had with Gigi or Gian, right? 13 years old, and the stories that he told about, you know, how people would say, oh, you need to have sons who carry on your legacy, and then she would, you know, jump in and say, that's me. Here's this. He tells some of the story. Let's watch it.
The best thing that happens is when we go out and fans will come up to me and she'll be standing next to me and they'll be like, hey, you gotta have a boy. You and V gotta have a boy, man. Somebody carry on the tradition, the legacy. She's like, oi, I got this. That's right. Yes, you do. You got this.
Listen, it says a lot about him as a father, but the relationship between a dad and their daughter, you know, it's like the mom and son have that relationship, but a dad and a daughter, they were together. At least, right?
Yeah, I mean, it leaves you speechless. I have a 7-year-old daughter, and he was inspiring the way that he was parenting his kids and how he was making the time. And you saw him put in the work with his daughter on the court, and so it's heartbreaking to see that, but they were together.
Yeah, I can only think, you know, the first thing I thought of it, I said, listen, there's no other way to describe it as shocking, horrific, terrible, you know, and I can't imagine what they were going through. Kobe is gone, but Vanessa and her kids are here, and I can't imagine losing your husband and your child. It's just horrific.
Yeah.
What are you gonna remember about your friend?
You know, the biggest thing about Kobe, I think, is, I grew up idolizing him, just like a lot of us basketball players. And so you remember the guy on the court, but, you know, for a lot of us that know we have to transition, and I've since retired, remembering how he's been as a father, how he's been as a coach for his kids, how he has been as an entrepreneur, and a man outside the game. Those are the things that you remember. You know, everybody sees the tenacity on the court, but the guy would go out of his way to give advice, and some of the advice that he gave me, I'll never forget.
Here's what how I can describe how everybody's feeling around the country. I had someone who I work with, when I got to work tonight, they said, "This is the first time in a long time that I cried about somebody I didn't know." And that means you had a huge impact on a lot of people who you didn't know. Thank you, Roger.
Absolutely.
Bless you. Thank you very much. More on Kobe Bryant as tributes are pouring in tonight.